Now, the trouser is finished and we're going to start on the dress. What I've done with the dress is, this is where I opened up the seams that were in the waistline on the side seams, and I've just pressed on so that the seams are open. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to center this. So I've absolutely halved it, and then at the half point I'm going to just notch this so I know where the center is. Now that is already partly done. Now going on to my dresses, the bottom area of the dress. This is the front of the dress. No, this is the back of the dress. This is the back of the dress, and what I've done is I've crease marked this. Now I'm going to be placing darts in at the back. So where I've actually creased it, I'm going to, these are going to be about 8-inch darts. Starting at the bottom, I'm going to, this is at the four point, that's going to be the fullest dart point. I'm going to sort of go in about 4 inches up and then come out again. So at the top end, I'm just slightly about less than half an inch has been taken in. So that's one dart, and I'm going to be doing exactly the same with the second one, making sure that I start off. Now pre-mark yours. It's better to pre-mark them than get the mistake of start off going in at 4 inches up and then out again. So this is the back of my dress, and what I've done is I've taken it in on the waistline because I want more of a fitted look. So once that's done, put that to a side. Work on your front piece. Now the front piece, if you remember, that was wider. I have actually pre-notched this and I've crease marked this also. Again, I've left approximately 7.5 to 8 inch distance in between. This is the center, and then 4 inches on the outer side of both those lines I have actually crease marked it. And again, what I'm going to do is, just grabbing hold at the bottom, I'm going to dart this, taking it in on about 4 inches in and then taking it out again on the fullest bust point. Now my darts are in, and I'm going to attach this to my dress. So, matching my center notch to the center, placing the fabric, the dress fabric, that the bottom half of the dress underneath, and placing the other one on top. I'm just going to seam this across. Show you what that is like. That is the result that I've got. Now, a couple of things I'm going to do before I actually go any further. I'm not going to attach the back one as yet because I want to add the ribbon onto this before I go on to doing the back one. So before I go on to adding the ribbon, I'm going to overlock this seam, press it into place, and then add the ribbon.